Prince Philip was described in life as being a real foodie. In contrast to the tastes of his more traditional wife, the royal consort to Queen Elizabeth II was a garlic lover, a curry enthusiast, and a spice buff, who was no stranger to cooking both his family and his staff a hot dinner on the grill. The Duke of Edinburgh not only knew his way around a kitchen, he was also not afraid to get a little bit contentious about food. Take, for example, the time that Philip ate a meal prepared by chef Régis Crépy: bacon, eggs, smoked salmon, kedgeree, croissants, and pain au chocolat. Afterward, he declared, quote, "The French don't know how to cook breakfast." Or consider the time when visiting the Scottish Women's Institute that the prince rebelliously quipped, "British women can't cook." The prince was so intent on having things his way, royal footman Charles Oliver once wrote in the book Dinner at Buckingham Palace that Philip used to travel with an electric glass-lidded frying pan. He cooked up his own morning meals, including bacon, smoked haddock, omelets, and sausages. Once, he even shot, cleaned, and cooked a snipe bird on his own. And it was exactly because Philip liked food so much that he may have preferred to dine without his wife. Royal chef Darren McGrady explained to Delish, "Prince Philip has a much broader palate than Her Majesty when it comes to food. The Queen eats to live, whereas Prince Philip lives to eat."
Prince Philip not only loved to eat, but he loved to cook as well.
Of course, Queen Elizabeth's much more subdued dietary preferences always won out when the married couple dined together. It was always down to the Queen is hosting the meal, so you have everything how she likes it. So I think sometimes Prince Philip actually enjoyed eating on his own. Just ask Woman's Day journalist Alyssa Sonsi, who tried eating like Queen Elizabeth for a week. If you like a lot of flavor, it's hard. The writer described the Queen's diet as painfully monotonous and bland, noting Her Majesty's affinity for breakfast cereals, grilled chicken, steamed veggies, and cucumber sandwiches. Not exactly the diet filled with spicy curries that Prince Philip is said to have enjoyed. Then there's the fact that royals were generally told to stay away from Philip's favorite ingredients in order to keep their breath smelling unobjectionable for public appearances. That means no garlic or onions, much to the outrage of many a gourmand. When Prince Philip retired from royal life in 2017, he moved permanently to the Royals' Sandringham estate in Norfolk, England. Queen Elizabeth, meanwhile, stayed at Buckingham Palace. It's safe to bet that at Sandringham, the Duke of Edinburgh's culinary preferences ruled the roost. At least, that is, until the winter holidays, when his wife joined him to celebrate Christmas. Another point of disagreement between Her Majesty and His Royal Highness? Drinks. Queen Elizabeth may be faithful to her gin, German sweet wines, and champagnes, but her husband, like his grandson Prince William, was a beer person. When dining with the Prime Minister of Italy, Philip once turned down every single one of the wines offered to him, reportedly saying, "Get me a beer. I don't care what kind it is, just get me a beer." It wasn't all stormy weather when it came to the meals that the Queen and her consort shared together. As in any happy marriage, sometimes Queen Elizabeth and Prince Philip met in the middle. Darren McGrady told Delish that the two royals both had a soft spot for fresh salmon, and on more than one occasion, the Duke of Edinburgh was known to cook a meal for both him and his wife. Oliver wrote, "The prince is also adept at producing quick, light supper snacks, which he and the Queen often enjoy after they have dismissed the servants for the night." After hours, Philip would reportedly make his wife dishes such as scrambled eggs and smoked haddock, mushrooms sautéed in butter with bacon, and Scotch woodcock. Presumably, the prince was free to add a bit of extra garlic and spices to his midnight meals. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about the royal family are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.